you have achieved is just incredible. So incredible. People magazine have featured you.
No, it's, I mean, it's been a journey. I grew up single mom, never knew my father. And in a home that was, my mom was on and off welfare throughout my young years. And I was in a private school without the ability to pay for a private school. And for whatever reason, I knew from the time I was probably in the fourth or fifth grade that I knew we couldn't afford it, and I knew I didn't want to not have this education. By the time I graduated from the eighth grade, I had made the decision that I would leave home and go about 4 hours away and in order to go to this private high school. Throughout those years, I moved every single year trying to find a place to live. By the time I was 15, I became emancipated because I realized that, you know, in order for me to be living on my own and to be able to even accomplish things that I needed, emancipation was actually the right next step for me. Every year was a journey because I'm trying to keep my grades up. I'm trying to make sure I can get into a good university. And it's a challenge to live on your own at a young age. I didn't actually qualify for financial aid the way that I thought I would be able to. So I wish I could remember what the ad said, but I remember the impact on me was like, oh, I think I could make a lot of money if I did this. Didn't know what it was, didn't know I was gonna be selling knives. 7 days a week from morning to night, just demo after demo after demo. And I sold, you know, $30,000 worth of knives and made enough to pay for my first 2 years of college.
So remarkable.
And, you know, I look back and at the time I had no idea the profound effect that it had on me. And I went into corporate buying. And I don't think I realized it, but over the next 15 years, as I was sort of climbing this corporate ladder, I was essentially an entrepreneur inside of other businesses.
I've got an 18-year-old who always says, I'm not going to work for anybody. I'm always going to work for myself. I say, the reality.
So interesting.
The reality is not quite that easy.
While I've been very confident in my roles, I've been aware of the fact that I needed to gain experience. So I sort of charted out, you know, what are the things that I want to accomplish? What do I want to be known for and how am I going to get there? And I made a decision pretty early on that I wanted to become a jewelry expert and I wanted to figure out how I could climb that corporate ladder within that industry so that I could one day have my own jewelry company. So I now had my eyes on the prize of I'm going to be an entrepreneur, I'm going to have my own business, hopefully build my own brand of jewelry. Setting goals and understanding the path I wanted to go on allowed me to know when to say yes and when to say no. I got to find a way to incorporate this community of women who are celebrating success on a daily basis as the fuel to my engine. Mm-hmm. You know, to wake up every day inspired to go into work, to go to bed every night feeling so good about what I'm doing. Like that's the best thing that I could have ever had in
and
any
you're
career.
A mom.
And I'm a mom of two.
Two. And how did you manage that? I mean, people say to me, how do I manage? I have a lot of help and my kids are spaced out. You know, so yeah. You've got two young kids.
You know, in between taking care of a newborn, I was writing a business plan. It was hard to walk away from my career. I will say that once I'd gotten to a place where I had climbed the corporate ladder, I was now at the top of my game and I was commanding the kind of even just paychecks that I'd always dreamt of. And I was about to just walk away from it all. And I had to sit down and have that conversation with my husband because there was no way that I was going to have both of us working in really, I guess, either stressful situations or just long working hours. And we were able to together decide for my husband to stay at home.
The one question I ask everybody at the end is, what do you think has made your life extraordinary?
I think that what I'm going to call the angels along the way. I don't know how or why they were there to help me, but it was, whether it was a teacher in the third grade that made me feel, you know, love and support and encouragement. I mean, all throughout my journey, I would say there were teachers that had a tremendous impact on my life, but also just complete strangers that opened their home to me.